Jesus, we thank you. We give you the praise. We worship you, Lord Jesus. Thank you for your faithfulness. Thank you for your wonderful. There is no like unto thee. None can be compared with you, Lord Jesus. Oh, Father, thank you. King of glory, we want to be like you. Daddy, Lord, you are everything that we like to be. Father, give us the grace to be like you. Give us the strength to be like you. You are all that we want to be. Oh, Father, thank you. That we give you praise. We worship you, Lord Jesus. We lift up your name above every other name. Thank you, for there is no like unto thee. None can be compared with you. You are the Alpha. You are the Omega. You are the beginning. You are the ending. The Lion of the tribe of Judas. You are the Rose of Sharon. The incomparable God. The omnipotent, omniscient God. Father, thank you. King of all glory, thank you. Daddy, I bless your name. I worship you, Father, the head of all principalities, a merciful God. Thank you for a time like this, another opportunity to hear from you and to communicate with you in prayers. Oh, Father, thank you. Thank you for your children all over the world. Thank you for what you have been doing in our midst, Lord, since the beginning of this program. Thank you. Be wonderful. Thank you for so many testimonies. Thank you for healing, restoration, and power. Thank you, Father. You are worthy. You alone is worthy. Everything that I want to be, Lord, is like you. Daddy, Lord, give us the grace even to be more like you. In the name of Jesus. Zedibada bakuka kidi zakabodi dekede moko badida kida boda zoko badida kida ba zikabado kede kede moko kede badakidi zodi bakabado di kakede bo kadi bako kede kede moko badida zekabado di kadi kadi badako kakede zodi bakadi bako kakeda zedebada kudi daba kude dide Zede baka koki da kida badi, zada bado di de boko kede bada kidi boko ba, zada bada bade di boko kede boko bodo de bade di kake da badi, zada ba kuka kide bo da badi kaki de bo da badi ka, zada bada di de bo baka kede boko kadi badi da, zodo boko kede kade 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 boko kede badi da. Zudi baka kede boko kede badakida kadi bodo badi zakabo kade de dabo kake kede boko kede bodo badi dakida ba zudi bakadi bako kede boko kade badi kakida zoko bada kudi de bada dakeda boka kede di bakida zadi bako kake de boko badakidi kadaba zoko badakidi dabo di kakida Zadeba koke de bodoba de kake di bada kudi di kaba. Zudeba kake de bodoba di. Thank you, Heavenly Father. I commit tonight, Lord, your hands. I pray that you do a new thing in our midst. I yield myself to your power. Heavenly Father, take over my lips tonight. Speak through me and let your people be blessed. In the mighty name of Jesus, let there be open heavens. As you have promised, O God, that it is a month of divine acceleration. I pray, Lord Jesus, this shall be the season of everyone, O God, that will be under the unction of my voice, a season of acceleration in every area of their life. In the name of Jesus, you will confirm your word. You will bring it to pass speedily. In the mighty name of Jesus, I declare the service open in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Spirit. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. Good evening, everyone. Thank you from wherever you're journeying from. I want to say thank you for always being here for us. And I pray that the Lord is going to meet you at the very point of your needs in the name of Jesus. Welcome to the month of June. And the Lord has promised to do wonderful things in our life, just like he has been doing prior to this time. And God has specifically said that this month is our month of divine acceleration. It's a season of acceleration. So wherever you may be, before we go into the scripture, I want you to declare to yourself and say, this is my season of acceleration. It is my season to accelerate in my marriage. It is my season to accelerate in my ministry. It is my season to accelerate in my business. In my academics, it is my season to accelerate. It is the season for my acceleration in my destiny. It is the season for my children and my spouse to be accelerated in the name of Jesus. Thank you, King of Glory, for in Jesus' name we have prayed. Hallelujah. Tonight we're going to start by looking at what divine acceleration is, and I will move further to look at the principles of divine acceleration. Then we will pray. And through the month, we're going to be looking at other things regarding acceleration, what we need to do, what kind of enemies that might be a hindrance to divine acceleration. But God has promised to do something very great and new in our midst. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I want you to be very convinced in your heart and believe that the Lord is able to do all things. I don't know where you have been rejected before. I don't know where you have suffered reproach and backwardness. I don't know which area of your life you have been very sluggish, or you'll be slipping spiritually or physically. I don't know what area of your business has been slipping, finances or wherever, in your relationship, in your marriage, but God has promised to grant divine acceleration. Hallelujah. I'll take my scripture today from the book of 1 Samuel 10, verse 3 to 4. 1 Samuel chapter 10, verse 3 to 4. Hallelujah. And the Bible said, then you shall go on forward from there and come to the terebinth tree of Tabor. There three men going up to God at Bethel will meet you, one carrying three young goats, another carrying three loaves of bread, and another carrying a skin of wine. And they will greet you and give you two loaves of bread, which you shall receive from their hands. Hallelujah. So I want to believe that someone is preparing or is prepared to receive from the hand of his or her divine helpers, as God is going to be sending divine helpers that will elevate, that will accelerate your destiny, your way, even during this program, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Like I said, we're going to be looking at what is a divine acceleration. Before we do so, I want us to look at a scripture before we do so quickly. Hallelujah. That's in the book of 1 Samuel 16, verse 13. And the Bible said, then Samuel took the horn of oil and anointed him in the midst of his brothers. And the Spirit of the Lord came upon David from that day forward. So Samuel arose and went to Ramah. So it means that the power of God and the anointing of God, as I begin to make declaration into your life and as we begin to pray tonight, the anointing of God is going to come into your life. That anointing that will turn your life around and cause you to be a pace setter, just like David. See what happened to David? David was anointed in the midst of his brothers. And from that day onward, the favor of God continually located him. The power of God and the hand of the Almighty God move him forward, even further than his enemies and his contemporaries. So tonight, I believe that the mighty hand of the Lord that had done that in the past, who is still doing the same today, is going to do the same for you in the name of Jesus. Let's look at what a divine acceleration means. Hallelujah. Divine acceleration is when God extraordinarily increases your speed beyond what normally attains. Hallelujah. When God decides to increase your speed more than what is obtained in the society. Say, for example, in your business, a business that others have done for donkey years, say for 10 years, and they were able to achieve something through divine acceleration, your business can be transformed within 6 months because the finger of God, the power of acceleration is in that same business. It could be in the same location with where others have actually done the same thing for so many years. It might be in a career that you have been into for a very long time, but you are not fulfilled. But all of a sudden, when the power of divine acceleration comes upon you, then you see that fulfillment become. Fulfillment is not all about money, but all that will be added. Hallelujah. You see that peace of mind, joy is in your heart when you are going to your business. You are happy doing what you are doing. You are fulfilled. And the lives of other people are imparted. Hallelujah. And that is the drive that is pushing us, so many of us in the ministry, because that fulfillment is there. Even in midst of those challenges, we enjoy doing what we are doing to impact lives, to preach the gospel and win souls for Jesus, to pray for people and see them get healed and get well, and see them come out of that trouble that the enemy has put them or they have put themselves. Hallelujah. So we are very happy. We are fulfilled. We are happy doing it, even when come rain or shine, because there is a fulfillment. The hand of the Lord is upon our lives. I pray that tonight, that same hand of the Lord is going to come upon you greatly in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. So divine acceleration. When God makes you a pace setter like David became after being anointed as king in the book of 1 Samuel 18, verse 7. When he was anointed a king in that scripture, he became a pace setter, someone who was like a rearer of animals, who was in the bush taking care of animals in the bush. He became a pace setter. So I want to prophetically speak to the life of somebody that is listening to me at this instant. It doesn't matter how long you have remained in that position of unfruitfulness. When we talk about unfruitfulness here, unfruitfulness financially, unfruitfulness spiritually, unfruitfulness maritally. It doesn't matter how long you have been in that situation, but I speak to you as an oracle in the hand of the Lord. As you listen to me right now, the power of God is going to meet with you, and you, your life will move forward in the name of Jesus. That situation of life that has crippled you for a very long time, that situation of life, unpleasant situation of life that has kept you for too long, the power of God is going to move you up. In the name of Jesus, you will become a pace setter. And before decisions are taken in your family, you will be consulted. Before now, you had always been neglected because they see you as a commoner. They see you as someone who is not relevant. But they have rejected you in the past. But I pray for you that today, the hand of the Lord is going to lift you up. And you'll be a pace setter in your community. You'll be a pace setter in your ministry. You'll be a pace setter in your family. In the mighty name of Jesus. Divine acceleration. When God fast track your destiny, your career, your business, and general life, all are fast forward. When God grants you speed, like I said before, what took others 10 years to achieve within a short period, God will move you forward and cause you to do tremendous things legally, not illegal things. I'm talking about legal things, things that are accepted in the society, not things that are dodgy. When God makes you a pace setter, when God fast forward or fast track your destiny, you see, you begin to do things and lives will be imparted. And there will be evidence that the hand of the Lord is upon your life. It could only be God to have done this. You saw the case of the children of Israel when they met with the Red Sea as a hindrance. It could have only be God to have done that. And he parted the Red Sea for the children of Israel to walk on the bed of the sea. That was a hindrance that was standing before them. But God gave them divine acceleration. And they move forward from that position where they were. Hallelujah. So I want to say to someone that is listening to me tonight, it doesn't matter what obstacle, what hindrances that are on your way of greatness. They have been there for a very long time. It doesn't matter. The power that raised Jesus from the dead, the power that opened the grave for Jesus, that same power is going to bring you out. That mighty hand of the Lord is going to lift you out of that dungeon tonight. I see that the snail that is moving around your head. I see that power of the snail that is moving around your destiny. The hand of the Lord is destroying it right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Every covering cast of veil that has been there for a very long time, that people do not even acknowledge or notice you, even with your skills, even with the qualifications that you have got, even with all the resources that is within you that God has deposited in you. But today, as we pray today, I pray that the power, the mighty hand of the Lord, the powerful hand of the Lord is going to meet you wherever you are and lift you out of that trouble permanently in the mighty name of Jesus. We're looking at the principles of divine acceleration. But before we go into the principles, I just want to give you what divine acceleration is. Hallelujah. We're going to take one more and then we move straight to the principles of divine acceleration. So divine acceleration is supernatural uplifting. The finger of God lifts you up, which no one can challenge. Both Moses and Joseph were uplifted by God to help God's people in the time of need. So was Esther. Esther was single-handedly uplifted by God so that she could be of a help to her kinsmen. God is going to lift you in that your location where you are. He's going to lift you from that family so that you will be the pillar in that family, so that you will be the peace settler in that family, so that you will be the mouthpiece for that family. You will be the mouthpiece for that nation. You will be the helper of destiny for someone. God is going to lift you up this afternoon. God is going to lift you up this morning, wherever you may be. God is going to lift you up. If it is evening, wherever you are, the hand of the Lord is going to come upon you, and your life and your destiny will be lifted in the name of Jesus. I want you to share this broadcast. Even if you are watching me right now, I want you to share this broadcast so that others can get blessed, because the Lord is set to turn lives. The Lord is set to turn destinies. The Lord is set to grant divine speed to so many. The Lord is set to grant speed to your destiny. I want you to share this broadcast, like our page, click on the notification button so that each time we are online, you will be the first one to be aware that we are online so that you don't miss out of this. Hallelujah. So I'm just going to move straight to look at the principles of divine acceleration. We'll look at a few of those principles, then they will begin to pray. Hallelujah. We're going to do more of prayers this month, as the Lord has laid in my heart that he want to accelerate the destiny of so many. And he said we should dwell more in praying to him. Hallelujah. He knows what you are going through already. One might be saying in his or heart, saying, oh, why does he ask us to pray? God wants you to pray. He does not really interfere in the affairs of men until you invite him. And that is why he said, I wait and knock at the door of your heart. If you will open and let me in, I will come down and sup with you. Hallelujah. So until you commit these ways into God's hands, until you ask him, in Matthew 7 verse 7, say, ask and you will receive. Say, seek and you will find. Say, knock and the door shall be opened. He said, everyone that asketh, they receive, and he that seeketh, he findeth. Hallelujah. Tonight, we are going to find him because he has said, seek me in the place of prayers. Hallelujah. So, principles of divine acceleration. If you want God to accelerate your life, then you have to do things his ways. You cannot be expecting God to accelerate your life and you are doing things that are contrary to his will. Until you begin to learn to do things the way of the Lord, then there will be no divine acceleration. But I pray for someone who has depended on himself, who has depended on men. You are depending on the influence that you have got, and you have been failing, woefully failing. I pray that the power of God is going to come upon you. Have mercy on you as you begin to trust in him and do things his way. The power of divine acceleration is going to meet with you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So one of the things that we're going to be looking at is hard work. Your hard work. Your hard work. In the book of Proverbs 22, verse 29, the Bible says, "See thou a man that is diligent in his work. He will sit among kings and not mere men." Hallelujah. So you must be diligent. For you to experience divine acceleration and remain in that pace of life, you must be diligent in all you do. Diligent in your marriage, diligent in your business, diligent with time, diligent in your studies, diligent in your relationship with God. Persistency brings victory. You must be persistent in serving our Maker. Hallelujah. So you must be diligent. The next thing that you need to that you need to know is be properly located. You must be properly located. Your location determines your allocation. Your location determines your allocation. You have to be properly located both spiritually and physically. Show me a man that is among thieves. He is going to remain a thief forever, except the power of God drag him or her out of that coven of darkness. Hallelujah. So you must be properly located. Identify where God has placed your destiny to manifest. Hallelujah. So if you are not properly located, when I say properly located, it doesn't mean that you must be abroad. No. It doesn't mean you must be far away from your home. No. There are so many people who are in the village and are doing very well, more than those that are living in overseas. So you must identify your location. How do you do this? In the book of Jeremiah 29, verse 11, the Bible says, "I know the thought I have towards you. It's a thought of good and not of evil." So you must be able to ask God, what is your location? What kind of thing does he want you to do? And you begin to find yourself among such people. Hallelujah. If you want to be great in this society, identify people that have been great in that area of your business, in that area of your career. Identify them and begin to see how you can relate with them. Begin to ask them questions. If you stay among rich persons, you are going to be rich, because wealth is all about information. Once you get this information, the gap between poverty and wealth is very slim. Hallelujah. I pray that you will be divinely located in the mighty name of Jesus, so that you'll be at the right place at the right time. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Then you're going to watch your mind. You're going to watch your mind, your mind. Proverbs 23, verse 7, the book of Romans 12, verse 2. The Bible tells us that as a man thinketh in his heart, so he turns out to be. So many of us, we have so many evil thoughts around our hearts. My brethren, I want to advise tonight that you begin to disabuse yourself of those negative thoughts. If you are thinking of being poor, you're going to remain poor forever. If you are thinking of being sick, because the devil walks with your mind and he begins to put fear inside of you. If you see to yourself, you see yourself less important, then you will find yourself in the midst of mediocrity. So I want to encourage you tonight as believers, be bold, because the Lord has given us the spirit of boldness and of a sound mind. He has not given us the spirit of fear. Do not allow fear to torment your life. Don't allow the devil to use the spirit of fear to torment your life. Hallelujah. So we are going to be praying shortly. Hallelujah. The next thing I want you to have is aggressive faith. You have to be very aggressive. In Hebrews 11, verse 6, the Bible said, "It is impossible to please God without faith." So you must be a man that is very dogged when it comes to faith. The Bible says if you can have a faith like that of a mustard seed, say you can ask a mountain to move and they will move. Hallelujah. So we are going to be praying. I want you to cry to God and say, Lord, let the heavens release upon me today divine acceleration. Let the heaven release upon me divine acceleration. Daddy, Lord, let my life be positioned properly. Let my life be positioned. Daddy, move me to that location that will cause my destiny to be transformed. That location that will cause my testimony to manifest. That location, oh God, that will cause, oh God, a tremendous miracle in my life. That location, oh God, that will bring about change in my destiny. Oh Father, Lord, let your power, Daddy, from heaven rest upon me today. Move my family, move my spouse and my children, move my ministry, move my business. Let my marriage move forward, Lord. Let the heavens be open and let the power of divine acceleration come over me in the name of Jesus. Let the power of divine acceleration come over me in the mighty name of Jesus. Let the power of divine acceleration come upon me. Thank you, King of Glory. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. We're going to be praying, but before we pray, I want you to ask the Lord for mercy. The only thing that will hinder divine acceleration, one of those things is sin. One of those things is sin. Because of time, we might not be able to go into all of that today, but in the course of this series, of this lesson, in this month of June, we are going to be looking at some of these things, enemies of divine acceleration, areas how God can move a man's life to the power of divine acceleration. Hallelujah. I want you to cry to God right now and say, Lord, have mercy on me. I am a sinner, have sinned against you in my thoughts, in my action, in what I have done and failed to do. Daddy, have mercy on me. Show me your mercy. Let your mercy prevail over judgment. Let your mercy prevail over judgment. Blind Bartimaeus cried unto God. The Bible told us that the Lord Jesus stood still and beckoned on him to come. And those that were mocking him, they said to him, be silent, he calleth thee. I want you to cry to God and say, Lord, show me mercy. Be compassionate towards me tonight. I know I've messed up in the past. I know I've sinned against you, Lord Jesus. I know what I know to do. I have not been doing them. Lord, what I'm not supposed to do, I have been doing them. Father, have mercy on me. I plead the blood of Jesus. Look unto the cross of Calvary where the blood of your son Jesus was slain. Baba, have mercy on me. Show me your mercy. Show me your mercy. Show me your mercy. Bakozade kedebo kabadi zikabako kedebo daba. Zekabo kedi kadibo ko kedeba dakida. Zikabo kake de kede boko badi dakidaba. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. You are going to pray again and say, Lord, move me to my place of destiny. One of the principles that we looked at is positioning and location. I want you to cry to God and say, Lord, divinely relocate me to my place of fulfillment. Lord, divinely, Lord, today relocate me to my place of acceleration. Divinely, Lord, move me. Daddy, move me. Daddy, move me by your power. Even though I am comfortable where I am, Lord, you look comfortable. Oh, Father, Lord, move me by your power tonight. Move me to my place of fulfillment. Move me to my place of increase. Move me to my place of wealth. Move me to my place of fulfillment. Move me to my place, oh God, of increase financially, materially, maritally, spiritually. Lord, move me, oh God. Daddy, I don't want to remain in mediocrity. Oh, Father, arise in your power. Move me to my place of destiny. Move my family. Move my wife and my children. As I pray for you, I want you to begin to cry to God. Ziba, Kudi, Dekede, Zakabadi. Daddy, I pray for everyone under the unction of my board. Every power that has limited them, oh God, to that location of failure. Every power that do not allow them to move forward to their place of healing. Every power, oh God, that have been pulling them back, oh God, that do not allow them to be the right place at the right time. Oh Father, I speak authoritatively, Lord, as I depend on your word in the book of Matthew 16, verse 19. You said, behold, Richard, I've given you the keys of the heavenly kingdom. Whatsoever you bind on earth is bound in heaven, and what you lose on earth is lose in heaven. Oh Father, Lord, I decree tonight, every power anywhere, every power anywhere, every structure that the enemy has put together, oh Father, Lord, I destroy that structure. Every structure, oh God, that is pulling this one backward. Every structure of failure, every structure of failure at the edge of breakthrough. Every structure, oh God, of failure at the edge of breakthrough. Every structure of failure, every structure of miscarriages of booting. When opportunities are about to happen, the devil will strike, Lord. That structure, I command that structure to be destroyed. I command the structure to be destroyed. I command the structure to be destroyed. For everyone that is listening to me right now, let that structure be destroyed. Let the structure be broken. Let the structure of the enemy be broken. In the name of Jesus, let the structure be destroyed. Baku zakadabada kede bodabadi. Zika boko kede kede boka kidabadi. Zodiba kaki deboka. Zodikaba dike boko bade di kakidaba. Zadaba koke debo kobado di debaki daka debo dobada. Zika boka kede kede boko badidi. Zadabado da kede kede boko kakidi. Zikaba kudubada kada. Zede bodobadi. Kadi kadi bakako kede kede bodoba. Zodiba kake debo kobadi. Zadaba kude kede. Every power that has vowed not to let these ones go. Every power that has vowed not to let these ones go. Every power that has threatened them. Lord, even in their dream state and physically. They said over their dead bodies with this one. So God, oh God, make it in life. Father, I speak, oh God, as your oracle. I pray that your fire will locate such altar and destroy them in the name of Jesus. Let your children be set loose. Let your children be free right now. Everyone under the yoke of barrenness. Everyone under the yoke of failure at the edge of breakthrough. Everyone under the influence of sickness. Everyone, oh God, under the influence of demonic affliction. Oh Father, I pray that in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, let, oh God, that power, oh God, disappear from their life. Let the power, oh God, disappear from their life. Let that power, oh God, disappear right now. Let that power move right now and go to abyss. In the name of Jesus, I speak to you. You that power, you that power, you that power that is saying no. Every prince of Persia, Bakazadaba, Udi debo dobada, Zike debo, Kobodo di kabadi, Zake daba, Kuke de kedebo dobadaka, Dikadi, Kadabodi kakidaba. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. You are going to pray again. You are going to pray again. There is someone that is listening to me. There is a conspiracy to ensure that you are not promoted more than where you are. But as we pray now, the power of God is going to set you free. You have been in that position for a very long time. And members within you, they are internal enemies. They have planned that it is impossible. They will never see you grow. They will never see you move from that level. But as we pray right now, the power of God is going to hit you. I want you to pray this prayer and say, Lord, by your divine finger, by your divine finger, every adversary against my moving forward, every adversary against my promotion, Lord, destroy them now so that my life can move forward. Daddy, destroy them now that my life can move forward, that my ministry can move forward, that my marriage can move forward. Father, I pray for your children, everyone, oh God, that are in this category, that the wicked one has conspired, adversary, human adversary, demonic adversary, they have conspired against this one. They said it's impossible. They will never see this one move forward. They will never see this one grow in life. Oh, Father, I pray right now, let that power, oh God, it does not matter what they depend on, but I come against them in the name of the Lord of hosts. I command the fire of God upon them. I destroy their yokes. I destroy their power. I destroy their power. Bako zoko badadi kaba. Zika de boko kede bade kake di kabade. Zadi boko kede kede boko badida. Zudi bakade kaboda. kede kadi zadaba kakida kidibo kakeda badi. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. You are going to pray. You are going to pray. And say, year 2021, disgrace my mockers. Year 2021, disgrace every mocker in my life. Every power that is mocking me. Every power that is mocking me. Whatsoever challenge in my life that is mocking me, mocking my destiny. Whatsoever affliction, sickness, delay, whatsoever it is, poverty, that is mocking my life, year 2021, disgrace them in the name of Jesus. Let them be disgraced. Let those mockers be disgraced. Let those mockers be disgraced. Let those mockers be disgraced. Lord, I pray for your children, Lord, as they are praying right now, every power that is mocking them, every situation that is mocking them, every circumstances that is mocking them, in the name of the Lord Jesus, let them be disgraced in this year 2021. Let your children move forward. Let them move forward, Lord. Let them move forward, Lord. Let them encounter a change. Let there be transformation in their life. Let there be healing in their system. Let there be transformation, Lord. Let there be a change in their marriage. Let there be a change in their relationship. Those that are drug addicts, oh Father, Lord, every form of addiction, not only drug, every form of addiction, oh Father, Lord, that the enemy has put on the will of your children, oh, wherever they may be, as many, oh God, that are under the unction of my boy, that are into one form of addiction or the other, we break that chains in the name of Jesus. We set them free from that addiction. We set them free from that addiction. We set them free from that addiction. Bakazadaba kudide kedebo kobade di kaba ziba koke de kedebo kabade di kabadoda zadiba koke de kedebo kobadi dakida kedebo kobadaka zada kodo kodo kedede bada ziba koka keda kadibadi zadaba koke debo kobadeda zikaboda kede kede kedebo kobadi dakidaba. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. You are going to pray again. Hallelujah. You're going to pray. I say, Lord, every power that is slowing me down or slowing my progress down, let that power die now. I wanted to pray that prayer point as you have never prayed before. Every power that is slowing down my progress. Every power that is slowing down my progress. Sickness could be slowing down the progress of a man. Challenges of life can slow down your progress because your mind, you focus on that affliction. You don't want to do any other thing because that is what the devil wants, actually, to occupy your mind, to occupy your destiny with all of those troubles, baggages. I want you to pray, whatsoever that is slowing down my progress, whatsoever that slowed down my progress physically and spiritually, let your fire destroy them now. Let your fire destroy them now. I want you to pray, let your fire destroy them. Father, anything, oh God, in the life of your children that is slowing down their progress in their marriage, that is slowing down their progress in their ministry, that slowed down their progress in the academics, that slowed down their progress, that slowed down their progress spiritually, let the mighty hand of God, let the mighty hand of God, the hand of God that divided the Red Sea for the children of Israel to walk on the bed of the sea. Let that same hand, oh God, come, arise and destroy this power. Destroy this power. Destroy these challenges. Destroy them right now. Let your people move forward. Let your people move forward. Let your people move forward in the name of Jesus. Thank you, King of Glory. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Before we take the last prayer point, peradventure you are here or you are listening to me and you are not born again, I want you to make up your mind tonight to accept Jesus as your Lord and personal Savior. Before I pray for you, hallelujah. I want you to accept him as your Lord and personal Savior. And if you want to take that decision, I want you to just say this short prayer after me. Say, Lord Jesus, thank you for the privilege to hear from you today. I am a sinner. I have sinned against you in different ways. Now I realize you are my help. I have no help anywhere. I realize my mistake. I don't want to go back to sin anymore. Give me the power to sin no more. Write my name in the book of life. Delete my name from the book of hell. Make me your own son. I declare today that you are my Lord and personal Savior. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' name, I have made this confession. If you have just made that declaration, congratulations to you. I want to encourage you to look for a Bible-believing church around you, wherever you may be, and begin to fellowship with brethren. You can drop us an email or give us a call, and we'll begin to follow you through and support you in the journey of your salvation. Congratulations to you. Peradventure, you live in London and East Environ, and you would like to fellowship with us, or you like to be attending, if you do not have a church, you want to be attending our church, drop us an email, give us a call, and we will make arrangements to bring you to fellowship with us. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I want you to lift up your hand as I pray for you in rounding off. Hallelujah. The power of God is going to hit you wherever you are. And whatsoever happened, I want you to share the testimony. Hallelujah. I want you to raise up your hand as I pray for you. Lift up your hand unto heaven. Heavenly Father, I just want to say thank you. The King of all kings, the Ancient of Days, the I am that I am, the Lily of the Valley, the Rose of Sharon, incomparable God, the omnipotent, omniscient God, everlasting Redeemer, Jehovah Nissi, Jehovah Sikenu, Jehovah Adonai, you that speak and you bring it to pass. Behold your children all over the world that are listening to me right now. Father, Lord, you have promised in this month of June that you will accelerate destinies, you will accelerate marriage, you will accelerate ministry, you will accelerate healing and restoration. Father, I pray, Lord Jesus, for as many of these ones, oh God, whose life, oh God, whose destiny has been slowed down by the powers of the enemy, whose destiny has been slowed down by one challenge or the other in life. I pray that your mighty hand today, even as I pray right now, let your finger, your mighty finger that created the heavens and the earth, begin to locate them right now, and let that affliction come to an end in the name of Jesus. If there's any power anywhere, any demon on assignment that is enforcing this in their destiny, every strong man or woman, boy or girl, young or old, throne or dominion, that has vowed that this one's life will never move forward, I declare their obituary today in the name of Jesus. I pray that if they refuse to repent, let the power of God for destruction. The Bible said that the word of the Lord is a two-edged sword. It means one side is destruction and one side is for blessing. Father, Lord, I pray, Lord Jesus, you release your other side of you, that your God, because they are holding your children bound, wherever they may be right now, Lord, because they have refused to repent. Oh, Father, Lord, and they are bent on destroying the destiny of your people. I pray, Lord, let your mighty hand of destruction, that it meet them wherever they are right now. In the name of Jesus, I declare freedom for your people. I declare healing. I declare fruitfulness. I declare increase. I declare marriages. I declare success in the academics. I declare freedom in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, King of Glory, for in Jesus' mighty name I have prayed. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I wanted to share your testimony. I like to share your testimony. I want to know what God is doing for you. And I'm convinced that the Lord, because he doesn't lie, he has said to me, there are so many testimonies that he has done since we started this program. And he said the month of June is going to be extraordinary. It's going to be loaded with so many testimonies. So I want to share in that testimony so that others will be encouraged. Drop me a line. Let me know what God has done for you. And brethren will be blessed. Share with brethren as well. And I want you to share this post, repost them, invite your friends to join us every Sunday evening at 6 p.m. London time. Hallelujah. So until I see you again, I want you to have a good evening, and the Lord will be with you. I release you into the week of fulfillment, the week of greatness, the week of divine health. You will not be a victim of circumstances. The power of God is going to go with you wherever you go. In Jesus' mighty name. Stay blessed. The Lord will bless you. I'll see you again next Sunday. Have a good evening. Bye.